I'm back. Welcome back to the Jemison Empire Awards 2016. I'm here with Daisy Ridley, nomination tonight for Best Female Newcomer.
Yes.
For Star Wars.
Yeah, just that. I'm not sure how many people have heard of it, but it was this film. The people that did watch it seemed to like it.
This is so weird. You would think that I would have known about a new Star Wars film being made, but it's just somehow sneaked out.
No marketing.
The last year for you must have been completely bonkers.
Well, it wasn't really, because I wasn't working last year. So that was, I mean, it was weird because I wasn't working, because obviously since I left school, I've been working, like, jobs.
Yeah.
But the past few months were odd, but it settled down kind of quickly. And now we're filming episode 8, so it's just kind of, it's like the 7th time again. Mm-hmm. Just now people know half the story, a third of the story.
What's it been like for you? I mean, obviously, I'm not trolling for spoilers, don't worry.
Yeah.
But what's it been like for you in terms of going straight, almost straight into another film, playing the same character, and getting to pick her up again so quickly?
What's weird is when I read the script, me and Ryan had a conversation, because now, now that people have reacted as they have, there were a couple of things, and I was like, I feel like this might be a little, like, slightly tweak things because of how people reacted to me in The Force Awakens.
Oh, yeah. So you feel like the keeper of Rey's flame in a way?
Yeah, I feel like now, because before I had a responsibility to myself and to the script, and now I feel I have a responsibility to everyone that's connected with the character, as I think we all do.
Yeah.
So it's weird because someone said the pressure's down, and I don't necessarily think the pressure's up, but it's definitely now there's like an expectation to be fulfilled.
Yeah, absolutely. Someone just sent in a question there, or more of a comment saying she's glad that her two nieces now have a strong female role model to look up to. And I know that's something that you've encountered an awful lot over the last few months, that Rey has been received so rapturously.
Yeah. I mean, it's almost crazy because I'm very young and new to everything, so I didn't realise like the disparity within the film industry. But it is a disparity within industries all over the world. So it does feel pretty amazing to be a representation of something that people are responding to and that people haven't seen before. And I think obviously the other women I'm nominated with, it, like, all different genres, and people are still responding in that same way. And that's a really remarkable thing. I think it's a very exciting time to have broken into the film industry.
Yeah, absolutely. And someone else also asked, what was your favourite moment working with JJ?
Favourite moment working with JJ?
Yeah.
That used to go, Daisy Ridley, every day.
And never got old?
Never got old.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Someone else just asked, I'm sorry I didn't catch the name, do you still stare at Mark Hamill and pinch yourself?
I mean, I don't tend to stare at him all the time. We do tend to have conversations. But every now and again, I am like, oh, this is cool. But I had 6 months of it before. And then even, it was actually weirdly, because when you're filming, you're like doing the thing. And then when we were promoting it, you're suddenly like, oh my God, I sat next to Harrison Ford. That's so cool. Because Mark obviously didn't do that much stuff with us.
Yes.
Because he was preserving the secret.
Yes.
So there are, and like me and Oscar played PlayStation the other day, and I was like, this is really cool. Yeah.
That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. So obviously you're working with Mark Hamill a little bit more now. Have you perfected the holding out the lightsaber to him? Is that something that, you know,
is it more of that?
No, it was very, very good.
Yeah.
It was very, very good. But I noticed that you filmed with Ryan Johnson.
I've been doing a lot of upper body work just so I can maintain that hold really strong.
Yeah.
And a lot of staring competitions so I don't get embarrassed and like, Luke Skywalker.
We were speculating at Empire that the opening of episode 8 might be you running up to him, holding out the lightsaber and going, you dropped this.
Yeah. I'll tell Ryan.
Yeah. Is there any chance?
We'll refilm the beginning. I'll tell him.
Any chance I might make it in the film?
Perhaps. There's a few funny, like Ryan's great because there are a few really funny bits in it that are, I think people are going to feel like, like everyone's in on the joke.
Okay. Yeah. Interesting. And then tonight, are you excited about tonight?
Yes. I mean, it's the first thing I've come to that, because obviously we went to the Oscars, but that was, I don't know, it's like a different thing. I think I feel more connected to this because firstly I'm from London and I read Empire and you guys have been so supportive the entire way through. This feels more like intimate and more, I don't know. And because it's fan voted and everything, it's just a different kind of feel.
Yeah.
But it's very nice, yeah. Looking around like, who can I talk to?
Oh, it's a lot of fun. There'll be lots of people.
And I'm with my family.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Yeah.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
And of course, you've got your Empire covers.
Yes.
Are they mounted by the place?
I'm having a bit of trouble because in my house I have JJ and Berkey, our producer, sent a few framed things and there really is a limit to how many things I can be in my own place. So I have my magazines stacked,
stacked
in an important place,
important,
but I just feel also the framers don't know who I am because I've been using them quite a lot. So I think if I'm like, here you guys, frame this for me, they're going to be like, it's a weird narcissistic thing.
It is a little bit, but
it's
yeah.
there because the one, you know, the one,
the holographic,
yeah.
The lenticular.
I mean, you don't even need to frame that. It's so sturdy.
Yeah, absolutely.
But
it stands
all safe.
On its own.
Yeah.
And I have to, I'll be glad to go in a second, but I have, while you're here,
yeah.
I have to ask about the Tomb Raider rumours.
Oh, yeah.
What's the situation with that at the moment?
I was not told how to answer this question. basically, I am having meetings with many, many people.
Okay.
But meetings don't mean you're going to do the film.
Sure.
So the fan reactions have been great because everyone seems to be very excited about the idea. But I don't even think there's a script yet.
Okay.
So the rumours are unfounded. Though, of course, there have been conversations, but I've had conversations, I mean, about 50 films in the past few months. So something is coming.
Something is coming.
Something is coming.
Awesome. Well, I'll let you go and enjoy your night.
Thank
Daisy
you.
Ridley, thank you so
thank
much.
You.
Congratulations. Thank you. Right. That was Daisy Ridley. And I think that's it. We're going to get... Yeah, I'll talk for a little bit longer. Who's Ray's father? I'm not going to ask her that. She's not even going to tell you that, even if she knew. Right, so that was Daisy Ridley here at the Jameson Empire Awards 2016. It's going to be a couple of minutes, I think, before we get someone else on. TV is on Periscope. Yes. Wait for the movies. Fiddy Bloggy So Man. Yes, great job with the interview. Oh, thank you very much. That was very nice. We're counting down the minutes. We've got about, I think, half an hour, 17:19, about half an hour before the Jameson Empire Awards 2016 actually begin here at the Grosvenor House Hotel. All very, very exciting indeed. Do keep your questions and your comments coming. How do you deal with not asking the spoiler questions? Honestly, we know that it's pointless asking spoiler questions, especially this far out. Episode 8 doesn't come out until December 2017. It's going to be a long, long while. What's she going to say? So, there we go. Do any celebs subscribe to Empire? Yes. Some celebs do subscribe to Empire, and some are put on our mailing list as well. Will you be scoping the awards themselves? We will not be scoping the awards themselves. Are you allowed today the food this time? I had half a sandwich earlier on. Haha, Liverpool. I really can't respond to that. Yes. Haha, Liverpool. Can we watch the awards live anywhere? No, you can't watch the awards live, but there is a live stream coming up. And if you give me 2 seconds, because Lucas joining me. It's Paddy Considine. Hello, man.
How are
you?
You
all right?
Man?
I'm good to see you. You all right?
Friend, yeah.
Yeah, good. Glad you could make
what's
it.
All these kisses and things.
Well, this is Periscope. Do you know Periscope, Paddy?
I think so. Yeah. Oh, that's what happens on it.
People give hearts and they'll send in questions and comments. So there you go. Someone said hello.
Hello.
That's nice. Nerdpool.
Hey, Paddy. Hey, how are you doing? I can't read the names because of my eyes.
I know, it's too far away.
Yeah, anyway.
How's he doing? Basically, I don't need to do the interview because they can just do the interview for me and just say, hey, Paddy.
Looks
how's he doing?
Thank you very much.
So how
who's
are you?
This guy?
Who's this guy? This is Paddy Considine.
Yeah.
Winner of the Empire Inspiration Award tonight.
Yeah.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you very much. Yeah. I'm not sure what that's about quite, but I was quite flattered.
Yeah.
When they first got in touch with me, whoever sent me an email said, they want to give you a Lifetime Achievement Award. And I was like going, what? Do they know something I don't?
Yeah.
But then it got clarified, and I went, oh, okay, then, you know, you feel a bit sort of
it's
humble.
Yeah, it's not Lifetime Achievement. This is basically one of those awards that says, we like what you've done so far.
Yeah.
There's room for more.
Absolutely. Yeah, that's the point. There's room for more.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And, of course, speaking of more, this is what you're working on right now. You look in incredible shape.
Yeah, I've been training for 3 months in Sheffield at the gym with Dominic Ingall, in the gym that produced like Nazim Hamid and Johnny Nelson and Kell Brook now.
Wow.
So, I've been working really hard, training and getting the fat off. And it's worked, you know. So, I'm feeling good, Nick, and I'm glad it conditioned me to do the shoot. We're 2 weeks into the shooting now.
Yeah.
And it's going really well. So it's one of those where I can't wait to get to work the next day.
So this is Journeyman. This is your second movie as director.
Yeah.
I'm delighted that you're back directing again.
Thank you.
So 2 weeks in, it's all going well. Can you tell the people what it's about, roughly?
Yeah, it's about a... where's Paddy's tie? That's a good question.
Where is your tie?
I didn't pack one. I forgot to pack it.
I haven't got one either.
No, he. Yeah. What about him?
This is the thing about the Emperor Awards. It's very casual.
Why does Paddy looks like a toilet brush wearing a suit.
Well, that's not very nice,
well,
is it?
Well, you know, you there get you it, go. Don't you?
You do get it, yeah. We'll block that guy. We'll get after him. So it's about a boxer.
It is about a boxer who goes into a world title fight, and it's the crux of the film is that he sustains an injury that has an effect on the rest of his life. So that's where the film is. It's about the relationships and how the people in his life deal with the change to him. So,
and the award tonight is for inspiration. Who's your inspiration?
I've got loads, and I've got a lot of people who inspire me, and it's hard to pinpoint one. I'm inspired by Robert Pollard. I'm inspired by, you know, musicians, filmmakers, or actors, all kinds. There isn't one sort of person. There's just many, really.
Absolutely. Well, but listen, man, I made up for you. Congratulations, and have a great night. Yeah.
Brilliant.
Fantastic.
Take care, mate.
Cheers, man.
Thanks
have a good.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
You, man. if you said that to my face, you'd get that right, innit?
And believe me, he's in shape. Cheers, man. Have a good one. Thanks, man. There we go. That was Paddy Considine. And we'll be back in 2 seconds here at the Jemison Empire Awards 2016. And by the way, yes, please try and keep the comments clean and try and keep them nice as well. Because obviously people can see these as well. And it may have been meant in humor, but honestly. Right, here we go. Down Periscope. See you later.